Today we're going to talk about how brakes work in your car, and especially the ABS, the anti-lock braking system. You know, people try to make it out to be this big beast of a complex system, but it's quite simple. So, quick video, how brakes work, how ABS works. Welcome to the Buttman Experiment.
Ta-da!
Now, before we try and get into this whole ABS concept, let's just understand how a normal disc brake works. Your car's tire, I've got it here, and the brake pad, which I've got here, just mounted on top like that. Let's just say you're driving along and brake pad's mounted and your wheel is spinning and you want to brake. So you press the brake pedal and the brake pad, which is mounted here, just clamps on like that. It prevents your wheel from turning around and you apply the brake. So that's basically it. Brake pedal here, so you press on it. That is a master cylinder. I don't know if you can tell from my handwriting that both my parents are doctors, but master cylinder provides the brake fluid. So brake pedal, you press on the brake pedal, master cylinder sends brake fluid to the piston here on the brake pad, which just squeezes in on the tire, brakes it, brings it to a halt. So now that we understand what disc brakes are, and our understanding of braking is that it is something to bring our car to a halt, and disc brakes do that. So what is the problem? Obviously, big problem is that when you clamp onto something like that, of course you've taken the rotational motion out of it, which is good, but because you've clamped onto it, you've locked it. So that means this motion is gone, but clamp and this sort of skidding is still there. So let's say you're trying to avoid something in front of you and you hit the brakes hard, but the disc brake has just locked you there. So no matter how much steering input that you give, it doesn't matter. You're still heading straight to that object that you're trying to hit. So that's horrible. And that is where you need anti-lock braking system. So that's where ABS comes in. Let's talk about it. So how does ABS work? Well, obviously we got a vehicle here, four wheels, left front, left rear and right rear. And we got a disc brake, which we will mount on all four. So here, here, here and here, and we've got a brake pedal connected to the master cylinder, connected to something called an accumulator. You know, the master cylinder contains the brake fluid, and the accumulator takes that brake fluid and uses a pump in here to pressurize it and then accumulate it. And up here, we would like to measure individual wheel speeds of all four wheels. So we've got wheel speed sensors on all four wheels connected to the engine control module. Now let's see the ABS working in action. Let's say for now you're just driving along, you're not applying the brake, and thanks to the wheel speed sensors, the ECM knows exactly what the wheel speed is for all four wheels. And now let's say you want to press you want to brake, so you press the brake pedal and the master cylinder has the brake fluid, sends it to the accumulator, and for braking it has, so now from the accumulator, we've got lines going into each brake. So whatever goes into here, into here, into here and into here, these four lines are called feed lines. Feed line. So for braking, when you do that, the accumulator through the feed line feeds high pressure brake fluid into all four brakes so that we can brake. But what happens next is what differentiates the ABS from the conventional disc brake, because till now, if you observe, what we've done is disc brake things only, because we've pressed the brake pedal, we've sent this high pressure brake fluid into all four brakes through the feed line, and we have pressed the brake, which is sort of clamping. But this is where the wheel speed sensors come into play, because they measure the rotational motion of individual wheels. So when you do the braking, the wheel speed sensors notice that we are almost, the rotational motion is almost stopped, that we are almost going into a lock, same as in the case of disc brakes. So they convey that message to the ECM saying, listen, we're going into a lock, there's no rotational motion happening. So with that information, the ECM speaks to the accumulator and says, listen, you're braking too much, you're locking the wheels, so like, can you stop braking please? And the accumulator understands that message and says, sorry, what I'll do is, I'll just drain some of that brake fluid back into me so that we can release the braking a little bit. So you see, The feed lines were what went to each individual brake from the accumulator. There's also another line that connects from all four wheels to the accumulator, which is called a drain line. Drain line that comes back into the accumulator. So it drains that some of that brake fluid back into itself to release the braking. And of course, you know, the wheel speed sensors are still measuring the rotational motion. Maybe the accumulator drained too much of the brake fluid, and now, I mean, obviously we're still looking this entire process, we're still looking for braking. So the ECM might come back and say, listen, you drained too much and we're going faster, we need to brake. So the accumulator says, okay, sorry, I'll give you back from the feed line, I'll give you some more braking. So you brakes it more, and then the ECM comes back and says, listen, you brake too much again. So I say, oh, sorry, I'll drain it again. And that is essentially it. That is the whole concept, the whole idea of ABS is not to brake at once and lock it. Instead, what we do is we brake, we release, we brake, we release like 100 times in a matter of seconds, even more. So that's that gradual braking, so that you never lock it, but incrementally you end up braking while still maintaining your control. That is it. What a beautiful way of braking without locking. That's called anti-lock braking system. That's how it works. And as always, thank you so much for your time. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more. Any other YouTube calls to action that I may have forgotten, but it's okay. I hope you understood ABS. I hope you found it as cool as I first found it when I learned about it. So thank you for your time, and I will see you next time. Yalla, bye.